Good morning. Today is the day. We have avoided it long enough. Today we define angular directions.
Oh, good.
Okay. Flippin' physics.
Yay.
We are going to use the right-hand rule to define the directions of angular velocity and angular displacement. The first impediment which prevents students from being able to correctly implement the right-hand rule is finding your right hand. So please, hold up your right hand. The second impediment to being able to successfully implement the right-hand rule is that some of my students think they are too cool for the right-hand rule. For some reason, students feel they are too cool to actually turn their shoulders and torso while performing the right-hand rule. So please observe how cool I am while I perform the right-hand rule without moving my shoulders or torso.
That is definitely not cool, and I know cool.
That is definitely too cool.
Yeah.
In order to not be too cool for the right-hand rule, please limber up.
What?
Limber up, people! Stretch! Okay, now that we have found our right hand and we are limber, let's do our first example. Here is a mint revolving on a turntable. The mint is revolving in a circle, and I have added arrows to the circle to indicate the direction the mint is moving along that circle. Now, everybody take your right hand and point your fingers along the arrows on the circle through which the mint is moving. Please, now everybody has to do this, including you, the person watching this video. Again, curl the fingers of your right hand to make them follow the circle through which the mint is moving. And then stick out your thumb. Your thumb is pointing in the direction of the angular velocity and angular displacement of the mint and of the turntable. Notice, everybody's thumb is pointed out of the screen. In other words, this mint and turntable have an angular velocity and an angular displacement, which are both directed out of the screen.
Wow.
Okay.
That's pretty cool.
Good. Now let's do another example. Again, we have the mint revolving on the turntable, only the direction has changed. Again, I have added arrows to the circle to indicate how the mint is moving along that circle. Please take your right hand and point your fingers along the arrows on the circle through which the mint is moving. And curl your fingers to make them follow the circle through which the mint is moving, and then stick out your thumb. Your thumb is pointing in the direction of the angular velocity and angular displacement of the mint and turntable. Notice everybody's thumb is pointed into the screen. In other words, this mint and turntable have an angular velocity and an angular displacement, which are both directed into the screen.
Mr. P, why don't we just use clockwise and counterclockwise? I think that would be easier.
Yes, okay. So, looking at this example, Billy, you as the observer, would you say this mint is revolving in the counterclockwise or the clockwise direction?
That looks clockwise to me.
Right. But to me, someone who is on the other side of the turntable, the mint appears to be revolving in a counterclockwise direction. So, who is correct? Is it revolving clockwise or counterclockwise?
We are both correct. It just depends where the person is standing who is describing the angular direction.
Correct. Clockwise and counterclockwise are observer-dependent directions. For physics, we need angular directions that are not observer-dependent, which is why we use the right-hand rule. Notice how, no matter where you, the observer, are located for this example, using the right-hand rule, you get that the turntable is turning into the screen. Let's do another example. Now we are looking at the turntable from the side. Again, use the right-hand rule. Curl the fingers of your right hand in the direction the turntable is rotating, and class, which direction do we get?
Up!
Up.
Correct. You can see the mint and turntable have an upward angular direction, which is also the positive y direction. Okay, let's change that direction again. Bo, this time, what is the angular direction of the mint and turntable?
My thumb points downward, so looks like the mint is turning downward, so the negative y direction.
That is correct. The mint and turntable are rotating in a downward direction, which is the negative y direction. Now let's turn the turntable on its side And Billy, what is the angular direction now?
It looks like it's going in this direction, which is the positive x direction.
That is correct. And now let's do our last direction. Bobby, please.
I think it's going this way, which is the negative x direction.
Also correct. Very nice, everybody. Now, I do want to remind everybody that the right-hand rule gives the direction of the angular displacement and angular velocity of the turning object. One last thing which can be confusing for students. The direction of the angular displacement and angular velocity of a turning object is normal to the plane in which the object is located. Let me say that again and illustrate it. This turntable is located on a horizontal plane. In other words, a plane which is parallel to the ground. And the turntable has an angular velocity which is, according to the right-hand rule, directed upwards. And up is at a 90-degree angle, or normal, to the horizontal plane. Which is why the direction given by the right-hand rule is normal to the plane in which the object is located. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.